In addition to chewing process, another important physiological activity takes place in the mouth. What is that? That is the addition of a secretion that is called as saliva. Saliva is introduced into mouth by the group of glands that is called as salivary glands. There are three pairs of major salivary glands. Number one, the parotid glands. The parotid glands are the largest salivary glands, each weighing about 20 to 30 grams. They are located near the angles of jaw. The parotid glands are purely serous variety of glands. They secrete the saliva which is watery in nature. That saliva which contains more than 90% water. And parotid glands secrete more than 25% of the total salivary secretion. And you can also observe the parotid duct entering into the oral cavity. The ducts of the parotid gland open on the inner side of the right and left cheek and pour their secretions in the vestibule. The other variety of gland is the sublingual gland, which is an elongated gland. It is the smallest of the three main salivary gland. It lies just below the mucosa on the floor of mouth. It has both serous and mucus type of cells, but the mucus secreting cells are dominating. It has multiple ducts, as you can also observe. There are about 8 to 20 ducts in number. And via these ducts, it is responsible to drain its secretion. The third variety of gland is submandibular gland. It is also a bit larger variety of salivary gland. It is partly under the cover of body of the mandible. It's also composed of mixed variety of cells, that is both serous as well as mucus. But the mucus secreting cells are dominating. Serous secreting cells are dominating. It has an S-shaped duct, which you can also visualize in this picture. And through this duct, it is responsible to drain out its secretion. The sublingual and submandibular gland secrete a fluid that contains a higher concentration of proteins and is more viscous. While the secretion, which is drained by the parotid gland, is a watery secretion. In this slide, you can observe the composition of saliva. The total salivary secretion is about 500 to 600, or even can exceed from this value at the time of needs per day. The basal secretory rate is about 0.5 milliliter per minute. It means that the saliva is being produced even in those situations when nothing exists in your oral cavity. That minimal amount of saliva, which is continuously being secreted out just to keep your oral cavity wet, is called as basal secretory rate, and it is only about 0.5 milliliters per minute. The pH of the saliva is varying between 6 to 7.4. Further, what you can observe is that saliva, being a secretion, is made up 99.5% of water. In this water are existing certain solids. The solids which some are of organic variety, some inorganic variety, and also some gases. In case of organic variety, the significant ones are those proteins which work as enzymes, like amylase, maltase, or lingual lipase, another significant material, lysozyme, etc. The presence of amylase and lipase means that there will be the initiation of carbohydrate digestion as well as the fat digestion. But no protease is existing. It means the protein digestion does not get initiated at the level of oral cavity. In other variety of organic material, you can observe the presence of mucin, mucus, albumin, lactoferrin, which will be discussed later, and immunoglobulin, that is IgA, etc. In the history of inorganic substances, sodium, calcium, potassium, bicarbonate, etc. In the lower box, you can observe what is written over here is normally glucose is absent in saliva, but it is found in saliva during which condition? Diabetes mellitus. So the diabetes mellitus makes the presence of glucose in significant amounts in the saliva as well.